Hey everyone, Adamx here, hope you're all doing well. And first, I just want to say I'm sorry for not uploading for a long time. I needed a break from YouTube to focus on other things in my actual life and also in my online career, and taking a break from YouTube helped me out with that. But I also want to say thank you for everyone that kept coming back to my videos every now and then. I really appreciate your guys' support so much, and for that reason, I'm back and I will try to upload more and better videos to help you all out as much as I can, while keeping the videos not too advanced, but keeping them easy, basic, and simple for everyone to follow them flawlessly. And with that being said, guys, let's get into the video. Alright, so first of all, my first video back is gonna be a Fortnite Season 7 performance guide. So as always, download the pack, I will leave the link for it down below in the description. After you download it, you're gonna need to extract it with 7-zip or WinRAR or the normal Windows extractor. After you extract it, you'll simply just need to open it. And in here you're going to see a collection of tweaks that will help improve your input latency and improve your performance. So we're gonna start with the registry basics folder, which will contain some registry tweaks that, while they're basic, they can actually help a lot with your input latency and gaming performance. So we're gonna start with disable game DVR. So most of you should already know this, or maybe have even done it. Game DVR is like Windows version of Nvidia Shadowplay, but no one, like almost no one, uses Game DVR, but it still keeps running in the background either way, and it ruins your input latency a lot. So to disable it, simply double click on it, click yes, and then OK. After that, for the next one, this is not really a tweak, but we're gonna need to do it and then restart our PCs right after to apply the rest of the guide. So simply just double click on it, click yes, and then OK. This basically lets you run like CMD scripts, which is why I'm going to disable it in this guide. It lets you run CMD scripts without having to right click them and click run as administrator, as that sometimes doesn't even execute the whole script. So disabling this will actually run the script fully with no problems. After that, for disabled power throttling, this is pretty self-explanatory. Windows has a lot of power saving features, one of them is power throttling. Power throttling is just throttling down your performance to conserve power. But for people with really bad temperatures or maybe laptops, you might not want to disable power throttling, as that can really higher your temperatures based on other people I've seen with laptops that did not have better performance after disabling power throttling, but they actually had worse performance. But if you're on PC, most of the cases you shouldn't be worrying about that, and you should just disable power throttling by double clicking on the registry file, click yes, and then OK. And then for the next one, disable Spectre and Meltdown Protection. I made a whole video about Spectre and Meltdown Protection before, I will link the video down below in the description, but as a summary, Spectre and Meltdown Protection are like security mitigations in your Windows software, which really mess up with your CPU performance. Disabling them helps a lot with latency and performance as well. So I really do recommend disabling them, but if you want more information about them, you can go ahead and watch my video, link down below in the description. To disable them, double click, click yes, and then OK. For the last one, disable transparency. This isn't really for your game, but it's for your Windows. Disabling transparency can make things a lot more snappier for people with low-end specs. So this is not really for your game, but it's for your Windows overall to be snappier. To apply it, double click, click yes, and then OK. Anyway, after you're done with registry basics, you can go back, and now you need to restart your PC or the CMD scripts in cleanup folder, and probably everywhere in the pack won't work. So please restart your PC for disabling limited user account control to take apply, as well as the rest of the registry tweaks. So after you restart your PC, you wanna come back here, and now you wanna go to the two cleanup folder. So in the cleanup folder, you're gonna see multiple scripts that I've made that are gonna help you free up space in your C drive. This can help a bit with performance and speed for people with really low space drive. So to start off, you want to double click delete log files and just let it run. It's going to keep going, and when it's done, you simply just want to click enter. After that, for delete temporary files, it's going to delete files in your temp folder, which are files you don't need anymore. So to apply it, double click it, and just wait for it to finish. After it's done, click enter. After that, for delete update cache, this is just gonna delete Windows update cached files, because you probably don't need them anymore, and well, if you've been watching my older videos, then you should already have Windows updates disabled, as I stated before why they could be bad. But anyway, if you don't have updates disabled, then you should delete update cache. Simply double click on it. When it's done, click enter. After that, for this cleanup, double click it, click OK, wait for it to load. And when it's done, you just want to check what you know you don't need. So most things in here are not going to be needed for any of you, but just in case it has like Windows previous installations and you need files from your old Windows downloads, then just don't delete that. But anyway, you should not really need anything in here. So when done, just click OK and click delete files. You can let it run in the background and we can now move on with the pack. After you're done, you can now go back and now go to the 3 power plant folder. In here you're gonna see my own power plant that I made, which is really good for performance and latency. So to import it and use it on your PC, simply double click 1 import Adamx power plant. After that, click enter. And then for 2 delete other power plants, this is basically gonna delete the default Windows power plants, which is balanced, power saving and high performance. Because Windows sometimes might switch automatically to a different power plan, and you definitely don't want it switching off a good power plan like mine to something like power saving or balanced. So simply just double click to delete other power plans and then click enter. After that, you can now go back to the 4 programs tab. In here we're gonna start with Adware Cleaner. Simply just double click on it and it's gonna open your browser and download Adware Cleaner for you. After Adware Cleaner is downloaded, you wanna open it and then click I agree. And then you want to go to settings, scroll all the way down and uncheck terminate all processes before cleaning and anonymously help the community by providing usage and threat statistics. After that, you can go to dashboard again and click scan now. After the scan is done, if there is anything detected, just click quarantine, but if there is not, you can just click skip basic repair and then close Adware Cleaner. Alright, so after you're done with Adware Cleaner, you can now open Auto Runs. AutoRuns is basically a program that lets you disable any drivers, services, or applications from starting as soon as your PC opens. But this program can be a little too hard or confusing for some people that are not that good about PCs. So simply I'm just gonna cover the logon tab, which is really simple and basic. So in here you just wanna disable any program you know you don't need to start as soon as your PC opens. So for example, Discord or Spotify, if you don't need them starting as soon as your PC opens, then you can just uncheck them right here. Same thing with any software that shows up right here for you, if you don't need it, disable it. After you're done, you can exit out of AutoRuns. After that, you now want to download MSI Afterburner. But the version we're gonna download right here is 4.6.2, which is the version before they applied their new GUI, since I honestly don't like it, but if you want, you can just download the latest version from their website. After the MSI Afterburner installer is downloaded, you can simply just open it and then click OK. Click next, click I accept, then click next, uncheck Riva Tuner Statistics Server, click next, and then click next again, and next and install. Wait for it to finish installing, and after it's done, just click run MSI Afterburner. So in here there is a lot that you can really do, but since this video is supposed to be simple and basic, I'm not gonna cover everything. I'm just gonna cover your power limits and your fan speed. So for most people I've seen, they leave their fan speed on auto and their power limit on auto as well. So for your power limit, you can just maximize it, and for your fan speed, you can higher it as high as you can, as long as the noise doesn't annoy you. The max I recommend for most people would be around 80 to 90. For me, 60 just suits me for daily use, and when I'm playing any game, I just set it to 80. Other than that, when I'm recording, I put my fan speed to the lowest, so my microphone doesn't pick up the fan noise. That's as well why my temperatures are a bit high right now. Anyway, after you set your fan speeds right here to whatever you want, you can simply just click the tick button right here, then click the save logo right here, and then click 1 or 2 or whatever you want to save this profile to. After that, you want to check the Windows icon right here, so MSI Afterburner automatically runs as soon as your PC opens, applies the settings we just set right here, and then automatically closes. This will just make sure that these settings are always applied, even when you restart your PC. But anyway, after you're done, just close MSI Afterburner. After you're done with MSI Afterburner, you now want to double click MSI Mood Utility 3.0. In here there is not much that we will do, we're just gonna enable MSI mode for supported devices. So I will leave a forum in the description of this video explaining why MSI mode, also known as message signaled interrupts mode, is better than light based, which is the default for a lot of devices. But anyway, in here you wanna check MSI mode for devices that support it. So you wanna go beside your GPU, and then go to the column where it says supported modes. If under supported modes it says MSI beside your GPU, then that means your GPU supports MSI mode. If it supports MSI mode, then make sure to check the MSI box right here. You wanna do the same thing for devices that support MSI mode. After you're done, you can simply just click apply and exit out of MSI mode utility. After you're done with the programs tab, you can now go back and now go to the 5 GPU tweaks tab. We're gonna start with the NVIDIA GPUs, simply just go to the NVIDIA folder, and in here you're gonna see a profile that I made that will tweak and optimize all of your NVIDIA control panel settings, and it will also optimize some hidden settings that are not visible in the NVIDIA control panel. To apply this profile, you can just drag base profile over to NVIDIA profile inspector, and then it's gonna say profiles successfully imported. After that, simply just click OK, and that means that your settings are successfully imported. After you've done that, you can now open your NVIDIA control panel by right-clicking your desktop, and then you want to go to the Adjust Image Settings with Preview, and make sure that Use the Advanced 3D Image Settings is checked. After that, you can simply just exit out of NVIDIA control panel again. Now you can go back, and now for the Radeon AMD GPUs. Just go to the folder, and in here you're gonna see registry files that I've made that will tweak some settings for AMD GPUs, also known as Radeon GPUs. So first of all, you can double click apply optimal settings, click yes, and then OK. This is just gonna tweak some settings in your Radeon GPU software. After that, for disable some power savings, this will basically disable hidden power saving features that you can only disable through registry, and you cannot disable them through AMD Radeon software. And disabling them is really good for performance as well as latency. Anyway, after you're done in here, you can now go back. You can now disable memory compression by just double clicking 6 disable memory compression. I will leave a forum down below in description explaining why memory compression is bad for performance and latency. Anyway, after it's done, simply just click enter. Also, it's here giving me an error saying that it cannot find the command that disables memory compression. That's because I'm on a custom Windows that I made, which removes features that are required for memory compression to even work. So memory compression does not even exist in the Windows I have right now, which is why it's giving an error. For most of you though, it should be fine. After you're done, you can simply just click enter. And now for disable mitigations, simply just double click on it, wait for it to be finished, and then click enter. And now for BCD edit tweaks, there's a lot of BCD edit tweaks that you can apply, but I'm not gonna mention a lot of them in this video, I'm just gonna mention two important ones. The first one is disabling dynamic tick, and the second one is disabling synthetic timers. Dynamic tick is basically a power saving feature, and platform tick disables synthetic timers, which helps with latency. So to apply it, simply just double click BCD edit tweaks, and when it's done, click enter. So that was it for the video guys, I hope you all enjoyed it and that it helped you all out. Please make sure to like and subscribe if this video helped you. Stay safe, and I'll see you all in the next one.